Welcome back, everybody. So today's video is going to be a DIY costume tutorial, my second one, and it is on a non-traditional Grecian goddess, a sexy one. I wanted to move away from that traditional goddess costume that you can buy at Party City or at other costume shops. So this is what I came up with. As always, I encourage you guys to like this video at the end and to subscribe while you're at it if you haven't already subscribed. So if you're interested in seeing how I came up with this very simple costume, then stay tuned. Okay, so first thing you need is a white bandeau, something stretchy. It could be padded or not, up to your preference, really. And you will also need some gold elastic trim. This is the glitter elastic from Dritz, and I've got 2 1-yard packets of it. And you will also need gold thread in order to blend in. So as you can see, I'm doing a stitch on the top and on the bottom of the trims, creating a ladder-like effect. When you get to the edge of the bra, cut off the extra trim. By all means, if you want to go around the whole bra, then go ahead. So more golden trim onto the bottom edge of the bra using the same type of stitch. And here you have the first piece of your outfit done, that beautiful bandeau. Next part is the maxi dress. I got some sheer fabric. You can get some thicker fabric, and I got 2 meters of that. I also bought 2.5 meters of gold trimming, and this is supposed to act like the rope on the skirt. So I found this really cool Grecian pattern, but any gold pattern will do that matches. And optionally, I got these gold rhinestones that I'll be sticking all over the skirt to glamorize it even more. So next, you'll want to measure your waist, since it's a high-waisted skirt, or if you want to wear it a little bit lower, then just measure it at your hip. And I would cut 5 to 7 inches out. Upon cutting off the extra fabric, match the center of the trim to the center of the folded edge of the fabric. Do a stitch at the top and the bottom of the trim that meets the edge of the fabric to fasten it. Now, using a fabric glue, this is Fabric Fusion, you want to apply evenly onto the mesh on top of the trim and smooth it out with your finger so there's an even layer of glue to dry. Now let the glue dry for about 4 hours. I let it dry overnight. So a few more security stitches on the top and the bottom of the trim on the other end of the skirt. Now for extra security, glue the ends of the stitches. So now, bringing back the extra trim, we're gonna make some bracelets, some stretchy bracelets. So just cut to the length of your wrist. Now invert the bracelet inside out and start sewing the edges together. Moving on to the choker part, measure the circumference of your neck and snip snip. Oh man, I rubbed glue all over my face. It looks like crusties. So using these eye pins, I am going to be sticking it through the pinched ends of the choker. You can use one of those
crimper endings for flat bracelets that are available as well, but this is all I had. Loop the other end of the wire as such with two pliers in this case, and then just cut off that excess wire and finish off that loop, and these will be where you're hooking the fastenings. For fastenings, I will be using these barrel clasps. There you have it. You got a bandeau, a see-through skirt, bangles, choker, and the high-waisted panty that goes underneath. And this is how it looks on moi. As you can tell, I'm a little bit of a confident lady. Now this part is optional. Take the gold rhinestones and just cut them up and glue them on sparsely across the skirt with fabric glue. Make sure they're really glued on there because you don't want them to go loose.
That you enjoyed this video. If you did, then hit the like button, and just as a friendly reminder, hit that subscribe button, especially if you like costuming videos, experience event videos, as well as makeup and very thorough travel vlogs. So thank you guys for joining me today, and until next time.